Pasco News Radio WFLA 99.1 FM.
I'm Ryan Gorman from iHeartRadio, filling in as the team here enjoys a long holiday weekend, keeping you up to date on the top news of the day and getting you set for the holidays. One aspect of this holiday season that's a bit different from the past is way more online shopping, which means more deliveries, which means more opportunities for porch pirates. So to keep your packages safe, I'm joined by Runya Monkerios, CEO of Crime Stoppers of Houston. Runya, thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us. And you have to figure this is going to be a big problem this year, right?
Yeah, it's absolutely. I mean, our culture shifted over the last few years, and more of us are taking advantage of online shopping. But listen, this year with COVID and the expansion of Black Friday deals, the expansion of Cyber Monday deals, we're seeing a record number of people go online. Actually, Adobe Analytics is estimating a 33% year-over-year increase from last year, a record-breaking $189 billion spent in U.S. online sales just in the month of November and December. And Forbes has indicated the same thing. Looking back at April of last year, we're moving to an online consumer marketplace. But what that means is, one, convenience, and of course, contactless delivery and pickup of items, but also an opportunity for thieves to take advantage of this whole system. And that's what we're seeing with these porch pirates.
So what are some different ways that people can protect their packages, some of which may contain really expensive items?
Yeah, and believe it or not, more of us are feeling more comfortable having expensive things delivered to the home. You know, a few years ago, you'd say, well, I'll go out and buy that because it's a little bit too expensive.
Yeah.
But more of us are just saying, go ahead and ship it. So what we're doing is saying, one, take advantage of those Ring bells, those cameras at the front of your house. Get in touch with a carrier. Ask them to possibly deliver the package at a time that you know you'll be home, or to change delivery, to do it in the backyard if there's an opening there, access to the backyard, or maybe behind shrubs at the front of your house. If there's an option to have your packages sent to your place of work, or maybe a neighbor's home or a parent's home, somewhere that someone that can accept delivery, or request signature. Say, I don't want this delivered to my house unless somebody's there to actually retrieve it and sign for it. And then a lot of people don't think of this, but go ahead and get a P.O. box. They're not expensive. They're easy to use. Or use those Amazon hub lockers. Not a lot of people think to do that. It's very, very, very easy to do things like that and really save yourself the headache of worrying about your packages laying there in the front of your house.
I'm joined right now by Runya Monkerios, CEO of Crime Stoppers of Houston. How did these porch pirate operations run? Did they just drive around looking for packages outside homes, or is it more organized than that?
Well, it's a network like anything else. And let's just paint the picture. First of all, online shopping is up. There's a lot of financial stress out there due to COVID. The opportunity is there because of contactless delivery, as we were talking about. And there's also decreased punishment. Believe it or not, when you look at criminal justice systems across the country, and the average person doesn't really report this to law enforcement. They may report it to their credit card company, certainly to the store that they purchased the item from, but they don't necessarily make a report. So it becomes a very easy crime. So criminals basically hop into a car. They drive the neighborhood looking for packages just simply laid out at the front of the house. And often it's a two-person operation. You have the driver, and then you have the person that very, you know, nicely walks up to your front door, grabs the package as if it's their own, walks back to their car and drives off. And so it doesn't cause alarm when people are in the neighborhood. It's not like a car speeding through. People are running and through neighborhoods grabbing packages. They're very calm about it. But all these things work together for the advantage of these people who commit this type of theft. And as a category, it's larceny. It's not bucketed out into something different, and it just falls into this big old bucket. So it's hard for us to peel back the numbers and figure out what percentage this is. We're thinking, you know, these types of thefts make up 3/4 of property crime, which is a staggering number, but it's hard to study. It's hard to identify. And those Ring cameras truly have helped a lot.
And carriers are also doing some things to help protect the packages that they drop off. Talk about some of the measures that they've taken.
Yeah, you know, they were making sure to knock on the door to see if they can wait to see somebody. You'll see them even park. They'll knock on the door and then go to their car and wait for somebody to open the door if they can. They'll make arrangements, as I said earlier, to park, to place the package behind shrubs or out of sight if somebody were to be walking by or driving by. They do text now. They'll say, listen, we're going to text you when we're making our way over to you. We're going to text you when we actually drop off the package. They'll take photos and text you the photo of delivery. And they'll also even go the extra mile and go to, as I said, to the back of the house or somewhere else, because they know this is such an issue. It's been a rising issue, but especially this year. And I give the carriers a lot of credit for working with consumers to make sure they get their items.
I'm joined by Runya Mancarios, CEO of Crime Stoppers of Houston. Now, law enforcement has gotten involved to help catch porch pirates. What are some departments and agencies across the country doing on that front?
Well, Harris County, our very own county here, the sheriff's been really, really doing a great job. They've placed multiple decoy packages across the county, and within them are tracking devices. And then once the thief takes it, the GPS tracker is initiated. Investigators receive alerts in real time. And then when the thief opens the package, a camera literally starts taking photos of the suspect. This is a ploy to deter this type of activity. You know, it's hard, as we said, to arrest these people. It's hard to charge them, especially in this political climate. But we can do things to deter this type of activity. And I think Harris County's been pretty smart in what they're doing.
And final question for you, are there any other types of issues, maybe not porch pirates, but other issues that pop up around the holiday season that it's important for people to know about and to take steps to protect themselves from?
Absolutely. Online shopping is a huge issue in terms of security, entering your credit card into appropriate sites and checking your credit card statements. We always say use one credit card when you're doing your online shopping. Make sure it's a secured site, the real site. Phishing scams go way up this time of year. And then certainly for those of us who will still run errands, and that number will decrease because of COVID, we really especially encourage women to shop during the day. Bring a friend along with you if you can. Be cognizant of what's in your bag, where you park. And you know, don't make those trips, and we're all guilty of it, back and forth to the car. Let me drop off the Gucci bag, put it in my trunk, and run back to the mall. Maybe you shouldn't do that this holiday season. And it's not about being paranoid. It's about having the best holiday season you can and give to one another and give generously. But be smart, because times have changed and people really are seeing an increase of crime, petty crime to more in cities across this country.
Runya Mancarios, CEO of Crime Stoppers of Houston, trying to help us stay safe this holiday season and keep an eye out for those porch pirates. Runya, thank you so much for taking the time to break all of that down for us. We appreciate it.
Thank you again for having me. Take care.